Welcome, doctors from the Caribbean. My name is Felipe Arroyave, president of Spectrum International. With me tonight, we have Dr. Edgar Davila from Puerto Rico. I welcome every single doctor that has taken the time to join us today in this webinar. And I'm very pleased to welcome every single person from the islands, from Central America, from South America, and most of them are from the Caribbean, of course, because this was catered for the Caribbean and for doctors in this area. So welcome tonight. Tonight we're going to be explaining to you how the market is shifting and how a lot of doctors are worrying about their optical places and their private practices. This is how the current market feels. We feel that we're always battling the internet. Majority of the customers in the United States are not buying contact lenses on the optical shops, on the optical places, or on the private practices. Majority of patients now, and you can experience this in Puerto Rico and multiple islands in the Caribbean, is that our patients now are shifted and they're buying their contact lenses online. So this is how every single practitioner that I talk to feels. They feel that they go to your practice, they get the best visual exam, they buy one or two boxes, but then after this, they go to the internet and they buy the lenses directly on the internet. The problem that we have is that if we were to lose contact lens patients, we're not only losing patients that buy contact lenses, because a patient that buys contact lenses buys what else? They buy sunglasses, they buy ophthalmic products, they buy solutions, sometimes they buy contact lens cases, and they come to our offices or our practices more often than other patients. So whenever we talk about losing contact lens patients, please know that this share is not only being lost for patients that are not gonna be buying the lenses anymore in your practice. This is a loss that you're gonna have in solutions, in sunglasses, in ophthalmic products, and many, many more products, okay? So a lot of doctors feel that this company is 1-800-CONTACTS, Vision 2020, Lentis Plus, or a lot of these sites on the internet sell lenses cheaper than what you actually buy those lenses for. So right now, the market is shifting to have contact lenses just like we buy coffee or just like we buy brownies or cookies or any type of sweet. These pictures were taken in Russia. Last year, we had the World Cup in Russia, 2018. And these pictures are from multiple cities in Russia where you can find contact lenses being displayed in these vending machines. So you can buy the contact lens. And actually, what I did is I translated the little piece that you see on the right side. And it says, warning, please pick your closest prescription. So basically, if the patient is a -4 and the vending machine only has a -375 or -350, the patient will choose whatever is closer for them. So this is how the market is shifting right now. Now we have mobile devices here in the United States and we have mobile devices in Europe that eventually are going to replace optometrists and they're going to replace visual specialists. Last week we were in Ecuador and we were telling doctors in Ecuador that this is extremely concerning for us. Because can you imagine if visual specialists can start being replaced by mobile devices? What do you think that big companies such as Essilor and Luxottica and all of these big monsters are going to do once they get their hands on this equipment? What they're going to do, and please mark my words, is that in 10, 15 years, we're gonna see a lot of these devices being displayed in shopping centers where patients can go there, sit down for 5 minutes, and then the machine will order the contact lenses or the ophthalmic products directly from the labs. So now we're going to jump the loop of the optometrists, of the optical place, and the patients are going to end up going to these places less and less. So can we compete with the internet? The answer is no. We cannot compete with the internet. We cannot stop technology. In 2012, Netflix approached Blockbuster and they say, we have a great system. You can watch movies over the internet. People are gonna be able to watch series over the internet. And Blockbuster, because they were really stubborn, they kicked Netflix out of their offices. The selling price for Netflix back in 2012 was $50 million. Can you please name one single store that Blockbuster owns around the world right now? They have shut down the entire operations and they have gone bankrupt. Whereas Netflix in 2018, their sales were, are you ready? $17.7 billion. So imagine, 7 years ago, they went to Blockbuster, they offered the entire business for $50 million, and now Netflix sells about $17.7 billion per year, and Blockbuster is no longer existent. So we don't want this to happen to optometrists and visual specialists around the world. We like you better than those mobile devices, and we want to see you progress and do something different. So the entire base of this presentation, and I'm going to tell you a secret that I always tell my customers, is stop contact lenses. Do not just buy contact lenses. Stop. You need to stop immediately. Do not sell contact lenses. Fit them. That is the correct word. We're not all A6-14-2. Every single eye is different, and every single eye should be treated differently. But because we're so busy on our daily lives, what we do is we think that everybody is a medium base curve and a medium diameter. Everybody's 8.6 and 14.2. But whenever we have those type of fits and we sell contact lenses, we don't fit them in the patient's eye, the internet is going to take care of the rest. If you standardize your fits, the internet will standardize it even more because they're cheaper, they're faster, they're more reliable, and people don't have to leave their house in order to buy them. So not every eye is the same and not every cornea should be treated the same. So the first contact lens brand that we're going to talk about tonight is going to be Mark Enery. And just like Dr. Davila was explaining, this is a company and is the biggest company in Europe, and they manufacture soft specialty contact lenses. Okay? So a lot of the questions that I get around the world, and please believe me, and it's not only doctors from the Caribbean. This is doctors from South America. These are doctors from Central America. These are doctors from Europe. These are even doctors from the United States or Puerto Rico. And they always ask me the same questions. Why doesn't my practice have an optimal growth? Every eye is unique, and it's all about the fit, is what I tell them. Diameter, eccentricity, and Kane values are important. Movement and centration are really important. But also, a lot of practitioners in Latin America do not fit a lot of multifocal lenses. So the base of this presentation is that every eye is unique. We have steep corneas and flat corneas. We have small corneas and large corneas. We have corneas with astigmatism, and we have corneas for presbyope patients. And we have corneas that need a presbyope multifocal addition, but they also need toricity because they're astigmatic. Davila? Dr. Davila.
Yeah, I'm on now. The key word during the presentation is actually personalization. The idea is to cater to the special needs of each and every eye. You will see it doesn't matter which type of lens we're using, all around the world, we have been actually paying a lot of more attention to the famous HVID, or the horizontal visible iris diameter. I'm almost 50 years old. If you are almost my age or a little bit older than me, you maybe remember years ago, the famous old Bausch-Lomb lenses, the U2 lenses. Those lenses were fit by sagittal height instead of base curve, because the first soft contact lenses were actually fitted using sagittal height. You can either order a small, medium, or large sagittal height. Then after that, the whole industry changed, and then we start using base curves. But actually, the base curve is one of the worst ways of actually fitting contact lenses. As you can see over here, people have either small coronal diameters or large coronal diameters. The average size of the HVID for the human eye is actually 11.8. But what happens whenever that eye is not at 11.8? Like as you can see over here, the small coronal diameter, discomfort after a few hours, inadequate movement and tear exchange, lens decentration leading to poor vision. If you have a large diameter, discomfort too, insufficient limit coverage and eye health. Like Felipe was saying, it is impossible to fit everyone using A6 14.0 or A6 14.2. Okay, next. So, as you can see over here, a dramatic view of why we cannot use actually case in order to fit. I know it's what we were told at optometry school, adaptive insurance school, or contact lens school years ago. But take a quick peek at these two corneas over here. One more click to see the figures.
Yeah. So let me piggyback on this. So you can see, and we can see this OCT view of these two corneas, right? And as you can see, both corners are different, right? But if we were to tell you that cornea A is 4350 diopters and cornea B is also 4350 diopters, and I don't show you the HVID of those two corneas, you will probably say, 4350, that's an A6 base curve. And you will probably go to your inventory in your optical place and you will pick an A6 14.2 for both of these patients. But if you don't measure the HVID of both of these corneas, you're going to end up giving one of those patients the wrong lens because that patient is going to be uncomfortable wearing that lens. As you can see, the HVID of cornea A is 12.2 and the HVID of cornea B is 11.2. But both of those corneas have the same K values. Hello?
Yes, and that's why I know they taught us to use case in order to fit contact lenses. But that's why, as you can see in those two pictures over there, that's why the case could be misleading. There's an actual movement around the world. A lot of different cornea specialists like Yves Van der Werf, Pat Caroline in different universities trying to change that and to start using sagittal values instead of case in order to fit. Because we know for sure that sagittal heights are the best in order to fit. So I don't know if you guys know this guy over here. This is Dr. Yves Van der Werf. He's one of the reference in the world in terms of the specialty of contact lenses. A few clinical tips that he mentions. Sinking elevation, sags, to better understand some lens behavior. Look out for corneal curvature and shape changes. Assess lens on eye performance, verify lens concentration, movement, physiology, and vision. What it means here is sometimes we think everybody is doing well with the 8.6, and we don't pay any attention. We don't pay too much attention to the actual fit. We have to keep in mind to actually assess the fit. Also, keep in mind that the range of regular sags in normal population is about 900 microns, while the sag of standard lenses only covers about 1/3 of the range. So if we use all the information that we have right now, we'll notice that we have been fitting contact lenses the wrong way. Okay, next. We believe that we can help play our part in putting the skill back into soft lens fitting. Of course, one of our skills is to actually do contact lens fittings, not to sell contact lenses, right? Self-contact lenses, like Felipe showed you a while ago, a vending machine can sell contact lenses. They don't need us for that. But in order to fit, we are the ones with the expertise to actually do that, okay? If we help more patients to get comfortable, the comfortable vision they deserve, to outstanding materials, great optical design, and importantly, a lens that fits. What that means is we need to fit the eyes, okay? Remember, fit and concentration is also important. If you change the fit, it will have an effect on the prescription. Of course, concentration is very important when fitting torical, multifocal, and multifocal torical lenses. This is one of the areas that we should actually explore a little bit more. We have the baby boomers. We have a lot of patients that they demand excellent visual acuity at far and near, and those guys are not being prescribed with nice multifocal corrections. Now, with the portfolio that we're going to show you, you'll see you have plenty of different options to choose from. Next. So why, from a more statistical point of view, why it is important to fit well patients with contact lenses? Remember that a suboptimal fit contact lens contribute to dropout rates. So in 2014, the TR Film Ocular Surface Society, they create a study, the contact lens discomfort workshop, the CLD workshop, contact lens discomfort workshop, in which they address why people that are being fitted are actually becoming by themselves or by ourselves becoming contact lens dropouts. So one of 3,410 patients that step in your practice, three will drop out, and that amount of patients that will drop out can increase from market to market. So we have markets in which 5 out of 10 they became dropouts, and the main reason is discomfort. So that's why we have the CLD workshop created by Tifos years ago in order to address that, and we have a lot of information regarding that actual story. Remember, if we reduce comfort, the vision is decreased or unstable. If we compromise the eye health, what the patient will do, they actually get out of the category. You will lose patients, and then probably they'll go other ways. In order to keep your office healthy in terms of a good patient base, you need to maintain your patients using contact lenses. Now, the ones, as you can see over here, the one size fits all approach that most contact lens manufacturers leads to, it creates just a commoditization of the contact lens category. So that's why, like the picture that we showed you before, that's why you can sell those even on vending machines. And sometimes the companies are trying to oversimplify the lens fitting process. But just by doing that, we are creating actually contact lens dropouts. So let's go back to the base of our knowledge on contact lens fittings, and let's fit the patients. The idea is we want to, it happens with our Mark Enovi, but also with other lenses, we want you to start fitting patients to maintain them in the contact lens category. Next.
Okay, so as you can see, every eye is unique and every eye should be treated differently. So this is why we have three proprietary soft contact lens materials. We have 11 base curves from 6.8 to 9.8. We have 7 different diameters from 13.0 to 16.0. We have 241 spheres, okay, from plus 30 to minus 30. And we have 30 cylinders up to minus 8, all in 180 degrees. But at the same time, we have multiple values of add that can range from 0.50 to plus 4. So we do fit the patient's eye. We don't have standard lenses. These lenses are manufactured individually and for each single one of the patients, okay? So one of the lenses that won the Optician's Award in Europe was a Gentle 80. And this lens is basically a biomimetic lens that has the same decay as a hydrogel silicone lens, but it doesn't have any silicone in it. So it has the same comfort as a HEMA material, but it has the same decay values of a silicone hydrogel lens. Then the next lens that you see here is the Saphir RX, and that is a silicone hydrogel base lens. We also have a Gentle 59%, that is a HEMA-based contact lens for patients that still want to wear the traditional HEMA lenses. We also have the Blue Gen and the Blue Kids, and these two lenses are special, very special on their kind. Why? Because they're one of a kind. These two lenses protect people from blue light and UV light and ultraviolet light. So basically, for kids or for people that are always in computers, always watching LED screens, lights, or people that work in multiple environments where they get a lot of this blue light. One of the questions that I always ask my customers is, what is the first thing that moms do right now whenever the kid is crying. So when you see a kid in diapers and the kid is crying, when I was a kid, they used to give me a spanking or they used to give me a toy, right? But not anymore. What the first thing that they do is give that kid a mobile device, such as an iPad or a cell phone or a computer or something like that, or a small computer, something like that. But we always are giving kids devices that have the blue light, and the blue light goes with us until we die, because our grandpas are still on Facebook, Instagram. So all of these kids or these babies are getting the blue light since they're very, very early in age. So we have a range of contact lenses for all your patients. We have monthly lenses, we have yearly lenses, we have 3 month lenses, and we have 6 month lenses. So whenever you see this Saphir RX lens, this is a silicone hydrogel based contact lens, and this is a monthly lens. The Gentle 80 is also a monthly lens, but like I said, it's a biomimetic material. The Gentle 59 is a HEMA based material, and the Saphir is a 3 month or a 6 month replacement lens. If you in Latin America and the Caribbean, there are still a lot of doctors that fit regular conventional lenses. We do have a lens by the name of Quattro, and it's a regular HEMA conventional lens that comes in a vial. These lenses will last for an entire year. So we also have that line of lenses available. So just like I was explaining before, we have a full range of custom-made contact lenses where you can find 12 base curves, 11 diameters, 241 spheres, 30 cylinders, 180 axes, and 15 different ads. If we were to compare this to other companies that you can find off the shelf, where you can compare this, and they only have two base curves, one diameter, 57 spheres, four cylinders, 18 axes, and three ads. As you can see, we cover the full range of the spectrum. Our latest addition to the Mark NUV line of products are lenses that come with blue light and blue light and UV light protection. And we have the first contact lens in the market with a first class UV filter and UV blocking filter, okay? If that is not enough, if having a lot of spheres, if having a lot of cylinders, powers, diameters, base curves, and ads is not enough, we want to take this a little bit further, and we want to specialize the fits that you do for your patients even more. So what we do is we laser mark all the boxes of monthly lenses, and we name them with your, I'm sorry, we name them with your patient's name on the box. So we're going to laser mark the patient's name on the box of monthly specialty contact lenses from the line of Mark NUV. They come in this black beautiful box that looks like an iPhone, and both packages come there, and then the packages are laser marked individually. So now we know that whenever your patients are going to buy the lenses from your optical place or your private practice, they're always are going to end up buying the lenses from the same place, because you personalize the fit, you gave them something unique, but at the same time, you even mark their names on the boxes. So we have two ways of fitting Mark NUV contact lenses. One of the avenues that you can explore is you can give us case, refraction, HVAD, and we will design the lenses for you. So again, case, refraction, and HVAD. And please tell us the modality that you want to use. If you want a monthly lens, if you want a quarterly replacement lens, if you want a 6 month lens, or if you want a yearly lens, just tell us that, and we will design that lens for you. You can also tell us if you want a silicone hydrogel, if you want a biomimetic material, or if you want a HEMA based material. So you have the power of picking the material, the diameter, the base curve, the name that goes on the box, and whatever fit you want to perform on that patient. Okay, so that's the first avenue: case, refraction, material that you want to use, HVAD, and the replacement that you want to give your patients. If you don't want to do that and you want to calculate the lenses yourself, you go to our website and I will explain it to you at the end of the presentation, and you can see my screen right now. We can fit lenses using this calculator. So let's say that we're calculating the right eye. They're gonna ask you for a replacement, just like I said. Let's say that you want to choose a 3-month replacement. Let's say that I wanna use a silicon hydrogel lens. Let's say that I wanna use a toric lens, okay? And it immediately tells you that the only lens we have that is a 3-month replacement with silicon hydrogel that comes in a toric is the Saphir 3-month lens, okay? Then we're gonna put the HVAD as 13, okay? Or 12 or 11.8 or whatever you find on those patients. Then we're gonna go with case. You can use millimeters or you can use diopters. A lot of people in Latin America use diopters. So let's use 4250 by 4450. Okay, so K1 and K2. And you can even put the eccentricity of the eye. If you don't have a topographer and you don't know what the eccentricity is on this eye, you can choose a normal eye, you can choose flat eye, or you can choose a steep eye. So let's say that is a normal eye. You can even insert the topography so we can see it. Okay, let's say that in the sphere power, you have a minus 20. Let's say that in the cylinder, you have a minus 5. And in the axis, you have an axis of 9. Let's say that your vertex at 12. And that the system is going to calculate the lens for you. So right now, if you see my screen, you can see that the proper base curve for that patient was an 8.6. The diameter, because of the HVAD that we picked, was a 16.0. The sphere, minus 625. The cylinder, minus 3. And the axis will be 9. And the beauty of this, doctors, is that this system will allow you to see what the actual sagittal height of each lens is. The actual sight of the lens and the actual sagittal height of the eye, okay? So this is a great tool for you, and I will write down this website later on the presentation, okay? Dr. Davila?
Yes, the whole idea is, as you can see, we want to provide you guys with a really nice made-to-order soft contact lens, but we don't want it to be a hassle. We don't want to take too much time of your practice in order to fit these patients with these lenses. That's why you can either do it by yourself, or you can use the calculator, or just send an email to us and we'll calculate it for you. As you can see over there, you have almost every modality. You can use silicon hydrogels or regular HEMA lenses, and then you can fit any eye you want without the hassle of spending too much time. So that's the first, the Marconi line of specialty made-to-order contact lenses. Now we have another, this is our second product. It's called Orion, and Orion are made-to-order prosthetic and aesthetic soft contact lenses, right? Next. We have different series, as you can see over there. We have the BioColor custom lens series. As I mentioned before, you can use these lenses as a prosthetic device, or you can use these lenses just to prescribe a regular contact lens with color. Remember that after Alcon years ago, they start to actually eliminate some of the lines in terms of, for example, toric contact lenses with a color. Now they're not doing that anymore, unless you're using the regular spherical lenses, the new ones that they have, like the air optic colors. You can do that, but not actually in toric lens. You can use a spherical lens. We are offering you, like I said before, aesthetic lenses in any parameter that you would like, and also prosthetic lenses for people with damaged ocular surface areas. Next.
Yeah, so I'm gonna piggyback on what you said, Dr. Davila. Sure. So what we wanted to do is we wanted to bring the best in the industry, okay? And this, for us, is the best prosthetic or cosmetic contact lens, made-to-order contact lens in the world. So they're made here in the city of Atlanta, and they're the producers of majority of the lenses that you see in Hollywood movies, okay? So like Dr. Davila was saying, a lot of people in the Caribbean would want to wear a minus 6, minus four cylinder, axis 10 in a baby green or in a baby blue or in a honey or in a hazel or in any type of color that they wish. And these lenses are not widely available in the market. So please know that now you can have any prescription, toric, spherical, any prescription, and you can add whatever color you choose. We also think that the prosthetic lenses are something like we haven't seen anywhere else in the world. You can actually make these lenses with a fitting set, and I'll show you in just 1 second. And basically what you can start doing, and I'll show you with this highlight that I have here, is you can start putting one lens on top of the other one until you find the perfect color. Once you have found the perfect color, okay, we can mimic that color and we will bring that pattern here to the United States and we will hand paint those lenses for your patients. Okay, Dr. Davila?
Yes, the whole idea here will be to provide your patients with if they need a prosthetic device, of course, next slide, any base curve, any diameter. We have even a fitting set that Felipe, like Felipe was mentioning. With the fitting set, you can create your own. Of course, if you need assistance, you're creating them. Of course, we'll help you with that. But there's a very simple fitting guide that will guide you in order to provide those patients with a prosthetic device or an aesthetic contact lens. For example, if you only would like to have a minus five, minus three, axis 40, and the same color as a color blends green, of course we can do that without any problem. That is actually a stock lens already. All we have to do is change the power. Any base curve, any diameter, we can actually use different underprints. We can change the if you need to cover the whole area, we can use black pupils in any diameter, 5.0, 3.7. The thing is, in a very simple set, you can actually start creating your own aesthetic and prosthetic contact lenses.
So just like Dr. Davila was saying, the lens comes with a fitting set, okay? And you're gonna see the fitting set, you're gonna see a white round tool here. That tool is to mimic the patient's eye. And you have multiple colors that you can play around and you can put one color on top of the other one until you find the perfect match of the prosthetic lens that you're trying to mimic, okay? Once you tell us the order of the lenses that you use within the fitting set, like I said, we will bring that design into the United States and we will hand paint it for you. If you don't want to use the fitting set, all you have to do is take pictures of the good eye in natural light and tell us to replicate that eye. But we need to know case, refraction. We also need to know if you need a black pupil or a transparent pupil. And we need to know what the iris diameter of that iris needs to be, okay?
We have done already a lot of different workshops using this set, and people really like it, how to actually work with it and create their own designs and patterns and being able just to provide a prosthetic contact lens for a patient with a disfigured eye or a eye with a glaucoma and things like that. We were mentioning over here a lot of different parameters. These are made to order. You don't have to use the one size fits all approach. Of course, we're personalizing the lenses for your patients. Next.
Okay. So as you can see, the parameters go from plus 20 to minus 20 in 0.25 steps. The cylinders go up to minus 10. And we made a mistake here when we printed this. These are axes 1 to 180 in 1 degree. Okay. And you can choose whatever color you want. You can even choose underprint if you want to hide the scar or the glaucoma or any type of scarring the patient has that you're trying to cover on top of the lenses that you're going to be applying. If you don't want to use prosthetic lenses and you want to use something that is growing extremely fast in the United States, you can use lenses for biosport metallurgy. So the biosport lenses are lenses that people use to play sports, such as soccer, baseball, basketball, or any type of sport, okay? We also have biomedical necessary lenses, such as lenses with UV blocker, lenses with cobalt blocker. We have lenses with lavender. We have lenses for people that have extreme migraines. And of course, we have lenses for color deficient patients, such as the red or the teal. And of course, if you ever want to use lenses for Halloween, we also have those type of lenses made here in the United States. Like I was saying at the beginning of the presentation, these people manufacture majority of the lenses that you see in the Hollywood movies.
Maybe if you have seen the Cantor produce people from Bahamas and Trinidad and Barbados, if you have some connection to the UK, these lenses are the same as the Cantor and Nicer lenses in the UK. So same quality, same designs. Of course, the price is a lot better since the pound is a lot stronger than the US dollar. So we can provide those lenses for you. The next type of lens that we're going to offer you, and they're already available to the whole Caribbean, are the Synergize hybrid contact lenses. Okay. Synergize has been in almost 12 years, but now we're able to offer you the latest technology in hybrid contact lenses. Next. So we have different designs in terms of hybrid contact lenses. Our portfolio, we're going to put our key components will be in terms of hybrids, will be the Duet Progressive, Synergize A, and Ultra Health FC lenses, and we're going to give you some information regarding those. Who is Synergize? Synergize is a company in the UK based in Carlsbad, California. It is the only advanced technology high-performance contact lens company focused exclusively on independent eye care professionals. What this means is they don't sell through the internet; they sell directly to you, because most of these lenses are made to order, so they need to be fitted. Okay, so the two big families that we're going to discuss tonight are the Duet contact lens family and the Ultra Health contact lens family. Next. So what is the hybrid advantage? They always mention the best of both worlds, right? The clear vision of a gas permeable lens with the comfort of a soft lens. So that's what Synergize, so that's what hybrid is. Next. The patients that are ideal in order to use these lenses are patients with astigmatism, patients with presbyopia, and even patients with corneal ectasias like keratoconus and inferior cornea. It depends on the family that we're using. They have different indications. We're going to review those for you. The second generation of hybrids, the Synergize second generation, they have a silicone hydrogel skirt. The first one used a HEMA skirt, and the decay of that HEMA skirt was not that great. Now, the second generation, that's the generation that we have available for you mostly, are a rigid GP center and then a silicone hydrogel skirt, both of them with really nice decays. I'm going to show you a picture of it. Next. Also, we have a hyperbond junction that bonds the materials at molecular level. If you have been in practice for at least more than 20 years, maybe you remember the soft burn lenses, the old hybrid lenses, they break easily and they cause hypoxia problems. Not anymore. With the hyperbond junction, it is very hard for these lenses to get separated. Actually, when they make the bottoms of the lenses, there's a combination of soft material and the RGB material, and it becomes one. So in order for them to break, it will be really difficult for that to happen. Okay. The proprietary material, as you can see over here, the GP portion is called Petrafocon A, and the decay is 130. So we have an excellent material with an excellent decay to be able to provide enough oxygen to the tissues on the cornea. In the Duet, the optical zone is 7.0 and 7.5 in the other. As you can see over here, this is an OCT. The cornea there, the lens there, and we have the hyperbone junction. As you can see, you can almost not able to see the difference between those two because of the way it is constructed. Next. So the duet lens, it is indicated for regular patients, for normal corneal patients, myopia, hyperopia, astigmatism, and presbyopia, okay? As you can see, the diameter is 14.5. You have a lot of different base curve in 0.1 steps. You have different skirt curves, flat, medium, and flat two. You can see lens powers over there. You can see the material, the silicone hydrogel skirt has a decay of 84, that's really high, and a decay of 130, the GP center. They have class two UV blockers, UVA and UVB. As you can see over there, this is the lens over the cornea in that specific patient. Hyper decay center 130 with a skirt of 85. That's the classical duet hybrid design, okay? Next.
Okay, so basically, just like Dr. Davila was saying, we're going to concentrate in two families of hybrid lenses, the Duet family and the Ultra Health family. So the Duet is for people with myopia, astigmatism, and hyperopia. And you can also have it for presbyope patients, okay? So again, Duet, myopia, hyperopia, astigmatism, or patients that are presbyopes, okay? And the Ultra Health lenses are for people with cornea ectasias.
Next.
Oops, sorry.
What are the ideal candidates for Duet? Astigmatism up to 6 diopters of corneal cylinder, and you don't need to use a toric lens. You can actually correct up to 6 diopters of corneal cylinder using a spherical lens, okay? Any patient seeking better vision, patients who notice blur due to soft toric contact lens rotation, people with halos and glare at night because of those toric lenses are actually moving from side to side, people that want to see really well in their contacts and they do in their glasses, contact lens dropouts, people with poor visual acuity provided by inefficient contact lenses, people who require excellent visual acuity because of their jobs, mechanics, carpenters, medical assistants, people who work a lot with computers, anybody whose hobby requires precision. Those are the ideal candidates for the Duet hybrid lenses. Next. And also, we have the Duet Progressive. The Duet Progressive is a hybrid contact lens. It is a multifocal lens. And we have what we call here the complete presbyopic package. We can fit emerging presbyope, moderate presbyope, and even advanced presbyopes. That's one of the advantages of using a hybrid platform to deal with presbyope patients. Sometimes there are some brands in which you have, for example, low and high in terms of fats, and that's it. Anyone in between or everyone going out of those parameters, there's no way to fit it. Now, with the Duet Progressive, we were able to actually fit everyone. And you see the different parameters in order to do that. Next. As you can see over here, we have two aspheric lens designs for the continuum of presbyopia. The at power range, it could be from 0.75 to plus 5. So that's a lot more than any other multifocal, soft multifocal in the industry. We can also change the center zone. We can either use it from 1.8 to 4.0. That's another advantage when we use these type of lenses. Remember that when you use regular bifocal lenses, most of them, they have just one base curve and one diameter, and then you cannot change the size of the optic zone. That's why some people are doing really well with them and some people are doing really bad with them. With these designs, you can change that and you can customize for your patients. You can adjust the size of the segment in order to be able to provide each and every patient, it doesn't matter which size of people they have, excellent visual acuity at far and near and intermediate, since these lenses are aspheric lenses. Okay, next. These are the center distance designs and the center neon designs. As you can see over there, you can adjust the zone. Take a quick peek at the powers over there. You can even mix and match just to be able to get the most out of your system. Like we were mentioning before, from early presbyope to advanced presbyope, we can fit patients using this. Another big advantage of using this type of lenses is that the centration is a lot better, since we're changing the base curve and adjusting it to that specific eye. If we have more base curve, we should be able to get those lenses to center better. And of course, that's the key parameter in order to provide patients with excellent visual acuity at far and near. Centration is the key word. Here, since we have different base curve and different scale ratios, we can do that. With other companies, that the one size fits all is you can get. Some people are doing well, people not doing well at all. Okay. Next. Also, these dual lenses, you can actually now even order them with tangible hydrapec. The tangible hydrapec is a coating that you can actually order with these lenses in patients from dry eyes or people having problems with contact lens discomfort. We can order hydrapec all these products for you. Now we're going to explain a little bit about Ultra Health. Ultra Health, like we mentioned before, is a hybrid platform that works with corneal ectasias and a regular cornea, okay? Next. This is the most advanced hybrid contact lens for keratoconus. Same thing as you can see over there, a GPS 130, a skirt of 84. This lens, a very nice and important advantage over scleral lenses is that these lenses, any hybrid, they exchange tiers. Remember, whenever we fit scleral lenses are almost sealed. The tear exchange is very minimal, but with these lenses, we can provide oxygen different ways. First way of actually providing oxygen is using high decay materials, as you can see the 130 and the 84, but also whenever the patient blinks, exchange with the tear perm, and then it will be really, really difficult for patients to have problems with anoxia or poor oxygenation while using this platform if they're well fitted. Okay, next. Who will benefit from Ultra Health? Okay, actually, like we mentioned before, patients with irregular cornea, patient after surgery, patient with primary and secondary ectasias, keratoconus, PKPs, like we mentioned before. This is what this lens is designed for, all these type of patients. Next. Also, patients that are already wearing GP lenses, but they want better comfort acuity, or even patients using piggyback systems, and they want to try new options to improve comfort or to avoid using different care systems, or just to provide them with a more stable visual acuity. What are the parameters of Ultra Health? As you can see, diameter 14.5, default values, go over the cornea. These lenses are fitted similar to scleral lenses. Of course, they're a lot easier because it's an actual hybrid lens, but they are not allowed to touch the cornea with the rigid portion. A lot of different skirt curves and a lot of different base. We don't use, with this lens, we don't use base curve. We use vault values. That is sagittal height. So like we mentioned before at the beginning of the webinar, we're trying to change the way we fit patients. We're fitting patients more now using sagittal height instead of base curves. That's why you have the vaults, the vault values in microns, okay? You see the materials over there and the UV blockers. This is the profile of actually Ultra Health lens design. See the peripheral skirt? It doesn't touch the cornea. You see the inner landing zone, and then you have the soft cushion of the soft part to be able to share the actual weight of the lens in the peripheral cornea. That provides excellent visual acuity and a lot of comfort while wearing them for hours and hours and hours, because remember, excellent decay and tear exchange underneath that soft lens, that's hybrid lens. Next. Same thing. It is a reverse geometry lens. Depending on how much vault you're using, you can use the fixed lift curve or the variable lift curve. On the left side, if you use vaults under 250 microns, that's the design that we are actually using. If you use over 300, this is the design that we're using. The variable lift curve is if we need more sagittal height, with the variable lift curve, which will be able to provide a lot of sagittal height to actually accommodate patients with advanced ectasias or advanced keratoconus, for example. Next. So this is the ideal fit with Ultra Health. As you can see, green on the center, this area around it, less fluorescing over there, but almost perfect centering lens, providing good visual acuity, okay? Don't worry about, we are going to later on provide you with some webinars on how to actually fit these lenses, okay? So right now, the idea is to actually provide you with the tools, and then later on, we'll have webinars on each of these products. In order to prescribe, very simple, it is not hard. Determine the vault, step two, determine the skirt, and step three, determine the power. So you have to jump over use the height in order to jump over the ectasia, then see how the skirt or the soft portion fits, like any other soft lens. You verify centration, movement, and how it stays in the eye. And then after that, a quick over refraction will be to the power. Very simple. These lenses are designed with simplicity in mind. It is a lot more simple than actually fitting gas permeable lenses, okay? Then we have the Ultra Health FC lenses. Almost the same platform of the Ultra Health. The difference here is they are designed for very oblate corneas. That means patients with refractive surgery. Remember that in refractive surgery, that area of the cornea actually very, very flat. Patients, they end up having case of 37, 36, or 38, while the normal population usually have between 42 and 45. Keratoconus patients, they have like 50s and 60s. Patients after refractive surgery, they have case in the low 40s or high 30s. It is not uncommon to have a patient after surgery with case of 37 and 38. As you can see over here, right, the keratotomy, post LASIK, even corneal transplants that are too flat, we can fit those with Ultra FC. FC means flat corneas. Next. You can see how it works. This is the profile of an Ultra Health FC lens. Over the cornea, not actually touching it, just an inner landing zone and then the soft cushion all 360 over to actually distribute the weight of the lens in the peripheral cornea like a soft lens will do. Okay. Who will benefit from Ultra Health? Like we mentioned before, patients after refractive surgery. You can see the pictures over here. Look at the case of this patient. Actual left, the same case, 39, 47, 38, 70. You wouldn't be able to fit a patient like that using a regular soft lens because you wouldn't have a lens that flat. With this system, this is an oblate system. It is specially designed for those type of patients, okay? An excellent added tool for your oblate patients. These are the parameters. Same thing again. This is almost made to order, specialties of contact lenses, in this case hybrids, the vault values, the skirt values, and the lens powers. So we have a lot of powers, different skirt values, and vault values in order to feed a lot of different patients. We're not using the one size fits all anymore. We are actually fitting patients, not selling contact lenses. Okay. Prescribing is the same thing as the Ultra Health. First will be the vault, then the skirt, and actually the power at the very end. Like you mentioned before, don't worry. We will provide you and later on with some continuing education regarding how to actually fit these lenses. But let me add something before we go to Euclid. The regular Luet lenses, you can also order them using a special calculator. Can you give me a quick pick up the calculator of Duet, Felipe? Let's see if we can show you the calculator quickly. So you don't even need for the actual Ultra Health, you need a fitting set. But in order to fit the weight, you don't need a fitting set. You can order if you want to, but you don't need a fitting set. You can order those lenses empirically. All you need to provide us is the case, the HVID, and the refraction. Once you do that, we should be able to provide you with regular duet lenses, even multifocal lenses. And if you have any doubts, we have consultation available to you at all times. So you will have no excuse in order to order these lenses. You can order them empirically with the calculator. You can use the consultation people that we have for you, or you can even order them with the actual set. Okay, let's go back. If you have any doubts, you can write those questions for us, and we should answer them without any problems later on. The next thing that we have for you is an Ortho K system, Ortho Keratology system, that is called Euclid. It's one of the best platforms around the world. Actually, it's the biggest platform. It is a company that is based in the US, but most of their business is being done in Asia, because of the high amount of myopia patients in those areas of the world. Okay, we are going to talk about tonight about Euclid Emerald. That's the platform of Ortho K systems. Which Euclid? Euclid, a 30-year-old company with long-standing focus on improving the lives of patients with myopia, provide Ortho K lenses to ECPs annually, more than any other company. Already 2 million lenses on ice around the world. This company, one of the pioneers in receiving the government approvals for Ortho K. Emerald has been approved since 2004. China FDA approval in 2007. And the first Ortho K lens approved in Japan and Taiwan. And why those countries? Because remember, the incidence and prevalence of myopia is really high in those countries. Why do we worry about myopia?
Mm-hmm. Hold on 1 second, Dalila. Something happened to my site. My chat, I don't know where it is, and there are a lot of people asking questions. There you go. Now we can go back. Sorry.
Perfect. Why are we worried about myopia? Remember, myopia is a lot more than a refractive condition. The prevalence of myopia has nearly doubled since the 1970s. It is expected to become the leading cause of permanent blindness. That's why we worry about myopia. Based on historical prevalence data and future projections, there will be 5 billion people with myopia by 2050. That means 50% of the world population is going to be myopic. Almost 1 billion high myopes by 2050. And by high myopes, we mean more than 6 diopters. If you were thinking high myopes means more than 10, 11, no. A high myope is, by the new definition of myopia, high myope is higher than 6 diopters, okay? Of course, that creates significant implications for planning comprehensive eye care services globally. Why? Because remember, if we have a lot of problems with myopia, then we have people with glaucoma, cataracts, and retinal detachments because of the high myopia. Next. Like we mentioned before, high myopia significantly increases the risk of more serious ocular health, including 7.8 times increase in retinal pathology, 3.3 times increase in cataracts, and 14.4 times increase in glaucoma. So if we don't take care of the myopia now, the world in about 30 years, we will be actually blind. So we have to take care of this. The Brian Holden Vision Institute is working with this for the past few years, and that's why you're reading a lot about myopia control. With the Euclid Emerald system, you can also do myopia control. And later on, we're going to provide you with a webinar on how to fit these lenses and how to actually do myopia control with Ortho K lenses.
The beauty about these lenses, and let me piggyback on what Dr. Davila is saying, is that we don't need a fitting set. Majority of the doctors that want to start fitting myopia control lenses or Ortho K lenses are always afraid because they have to spend $2,600 or $3,000 in a fitting set. Well, this is no longer the reality. Now we can fit Ortho K lenses or myopia control lenses without the need of a fitting set.
And that's really nice news, right? What are the possible methods for proactive myopia management? Research has shown us that is orthokeratology, multi-soft contact lenses, atropine, and outdoor time. Of course, in terms of Euclid, we are offering you the first one, orthokeratic contact lenses. Later on, like I said before, we're going to provide you with a webinar on how to do myopia management and on a webinar on how to actually do Ortho K. But as Felipe was mentioning, with this platform, you don't need an expensive set in order to do that. All you need to provide us is, next slide, we will give you more information regarding that. Why Ortho K? One more. One more. How it works. In order to actually do that, all we need is two simple measurements. And we have a really high initial fix success. One, perform a refraction. And by perform refraction, we mean actually you doing the refraction. We don't want auto refractors. We want you to do the best refraction possible. Then get your case, the simulated case on a topographer or your actual autokeratometer, autorefractometer. You can use those cases, not the autorefractor, but the auto case, you can do it, or either manual case, and then measure the HPID, because that determines the lens size. If you provide us with a good refraction, good case, and the HPID, there's a almost more than 90% chance that the lens that we're going to send you is the first one, is the ideal in order to be able to provide an Ortho K platform for your patients. As simple as that, without having to spend $3,000 in a set, okay? And then that's really nice news in order to fit Ortho K patients. While topography is not necessarily needed for the elision selection, is usually necessary for a follow-up visit and treatment analysis. You don't need to buy a topographer to do this, but you should at least have access to one of them, because whenever you start fitting this type of patients, we need to know what's actually happening in order to troubleshoot patients. And then if you have an ophthalmologist nearby that you can order the topography for them, we can show you in the webinar later on how to do that, how to get the topography, and how to actually troubleshoot patients whenever we have a resource that we don't expect, okay? But you don't need to buy it. Of course, if you are entering into specialty contact lenses, you should think of actually buying a real nice topographer, because that is becoming the standard of care in order to fit contact lenses. We have two designs. The Euclid Emerald have two designs. You have the irregular emerald and then the emerald toric. What's the difference? The difference is if you have astigmatism, as you can see over here on the left side, we have what we call apical astigmatism. And on the right side, we have what we call limbus to limbus astigmatism. If in order to actually fit well those two different types of eyes or shapes, in the first one, with a regular emerald, you can do well without problems. But in the emerald toric on the other side, you will need an emerald toric to actually be able to fit the lens with limbus to limbus astigmatism. Do not worry. Of course, like I mentioned before, webinars, we will provide webinars later on, and we are going to teach you how to do that. These are the characteristics of the design of an emerald sphere. You can see the back zone of the radius. Then we have a reverse curve. Remember, these are reverse geometry lenses. We have two alignment curves in order to actually share the weight of the lens. And then they have the final peripheral curve in order to provide theory exchange. With a platform like this, you should be able to provide excellent Ortho K treatment for a lot of patients. Remember, how do we use Ortho K? Ortho K, people, what they do, we get fitted, we dispense the lenses, then at night, people wear these lenses overnight. These lenses are designed for overnight wear, and they are approved for overnight wear. While you are actually sleeping, they gently mold the cornea, similar to the shape that the patient will have after refractive surgery. And then in the morning, the patient removes his lenses and is able to see almost perfectly without contact lenses or eyeglasses. That's how orthokeratology works, okay? Gently reshaping the cornea. Of course, This is this the effect is reversible. Okay, it is not it is not a fixed treatment like LASIK is. What are the ideal candidates for Euclid Emerald? Low to moderate myopes up to minus 5, astigmatism with the rule of the minus 150 or against the rule of the 0.75, e-values, eccentricity from 0.3 to 0.7. You don't have to worry about that right now. We can also fit patients without the e-values. And it's the case, most of the patients between 40 and 46. And a corner diameter greater than 11 millimeters. Okay, that's the patient selection for Euclid Emerald Ortho K lenses. For the toric, it's the same thing, except the area where the lens lands, it will be toric instead of the spherical. And then in this type of lens, since usually if you have limbus to limbus astigmatism, usually what happens is that there's a difference in sagittal height between one meridian and the other, and this lens takes that into consideration, so we can actually aplanate both meridians the same way, and then usually the lens won't decenter and will stay perfectly centered and provide the gentle molding that the patient needs. Okay. Next. Of course, you're never alone. One of the things that we try to do, and I congratulate Felipe for the past year, he has actually created a real nice portfolio. The whole idea behind all the platforms that we use is that you are never alone whenever you're fitting specialty contact lenses. I remember years ago when I started doing that, you have no consultants, almost no consultants. You have no resources in order to read. You have no webinars. Now we are providing you with webinars. We are providing you with educations without cost. We are providing you with a group team of consultants, even calculators in order to calculate everything. So you're not alone. You are always have someone to help you whenever you start actually using these platforms. All the platforms that we have are just like that. Never you're going to be alone trying to fit any of these type of lenses. And Euclid, of course, is not the exception.
If you ever want to fit patients with us, all you have to do is tell us ahead of time, 24 hours before, and you tell us, Felipe, I have a patient with keratoconus tomorrow. The patient is going to come to my office at 1 p.m. What I will do is I will send you a virtual room. I'm sorry. And in this virtual room, you can access it through your cell phone, iPad, or any type of mobile device, even your TV, if you have a smart TV now. And what we will do is, okay, doctor, the patient is coming at 1, and we will have a dedicated doctor for you for 1 hour to help you fit that patient personally. So like I said, we don't sell contact lenses. We build practices. And this applies for every single one of the contact lenses that we have talked about today. So if you want to fit Mark Enovi, if you want to fit Synergize, if you want to fit Euclid, if you want to fit Orion, if you want to ask us about how the patient needs to, what type of lens the patient needs to wear, please let us know so we can set up a virtual room that we can join in together and we can fit that patient together. You're not alone, okay?
That's the beauty of technology. All you need, you don't even need a big computer. If you have a smartphone, we can do it on the smartphone. Okay, in terms our next product, in terms of this is a gas permeable lens. It's called Ellipsis. It's come from a company in Europe. It's called Lenticom. It's a really nice addition to the GP to your UP page. GP corneal patients. The advantage of, as you can see over here, you can either fit patients with myopia, hyperopia, keratoconus, presbyopia, intolerance to other GP fittings, corneal astigmatism, even irregular corneas. And we have created a special set just for you. The set that we created, you should be able to fit normal corneas and irregular corneas all in one set. We did that, and we create that set for you because years ago in order to fit different patients, you need at least 3 or 4 different sets. Now, with just one set, you should be able to feed normal corneas and irregular corneas at the same time. Of course, that means a lot better for you in terms of cost, because you don't have to buy 3 or 4 sets just with one, and also in terms of efficiency. You have everything within one set. They're easy to adapt. The really advantage in GPs, we're not going to talk much about this because usually you already know how to fit GPs, but we are going to let you know what is the advantage of using lenses like this. These lenses, are aspheric lenses, and they have what we call a periphery control. So that means whenever you're feeding the patients, remember, if you're feeding a keratoconus patient, and you start getting steep, sometimes the periphery seals, and then the lens to corneal relationship is not that good. With this type of lenses, you can adjust the eccentricity, and then you can keep a good center lens to corneal relationship, but at the same time, you can adjust the periphery and avoid two things: avoid the lens being sealed, or avoid the lens having too much lift, because you can control the periphery of the lens with the eccentricity without changing the lens to corneal relationship in the center. So that's a really nice advantage if you compare it to other GP lenses. So if you are using actual GPs and you're having trouble using some of the old lenses, now we have a periphery control system for you. It's really a nice to use lens in a set that you should, just one set, you should be able to fit everything or every one of your GP lens patients. Next.
So we're almost done with the webinar. This is the last product that we're going to introduce to you today. As you can see, we gathered the biggest and the best labs around the world, and we brought them to work under the same spectrum of contact lenses. That's why the company is called Spectrum, because you have the widest and largest spectrum of contact lenses in the market. The next lens that we're going to talk about is the Scleral Europa Scleral lens. It's a lens manufactured here in the United States, and it was one of the first fully customizable scleral lenses in the market. Dr. Davila?
Yes. What do we need to know about scleral lenses, right? Lee Hoss says in contrast spectrum, for a scleral lens fitting to be successful, the lens should completely clear the cornea and limbus 360 around without pressure or bearing on either surface and provide apical clearance sufficient enough to form a fluid tear reservoir beneath the lens and in front of the eye. The lens periphery should also bear evenly on the conjunctival tissue that overlies the sclera to prevent conjunctival redness or blanching of the conjunctival vessels, right? So we have been, for the past almost 10 years, we have been actually fitting scleral lenses. For the past 5 years, it has become a trend all over the world. Scleral lenses are the latest lenses in terms of actually, especially contact fittings. The ironic part is that scleral lenses were the first lenses almost 3 centuries ago. They were first designed in 1887 and 1888 by German and Swiss ophthalmologists, the cults, ophthalmologists like that, almost three centuries ago. And now these are the trending type of lenses that we also usually use to fit specialty corneas. Next. In order to have a good scleral lens fit, this is all we need. Go over the ectasia, clear the apex. You cannot touch, one back. Clear the ectasia, you cannot touch the apex of the, in this case, if a keratoconus, but it could be a PKP or it could be a pellucid marginal degeneration. You cannot touch the ectasic area. Create an adequate liquid reservoir. We cannot touch the limbus. And then we have to rest gently and tangentially on the sclera without putting too much pressure. That would be the ideal good scleral lens fit. In order to do that, the Europa lens, we're going to give you the power curve that we have. Usually, all scleral lenses, they have usually 3 different zones: the central zone or the base curve, the limbal zone, and the aptics. The aptics is where the lens rests. And a normal first generation lens, we have at least 2 different curves. Our Europa lens has 5 different curves. You have the base curve, and the diameter, you see later on the diameter of the base curve. Then we have the peripheral curve 1, as you can see over there. That's the area over the limbus. And then you have the aptics that will be PC2, PC3, and PC4. Those are the aptics, those where the lens rest, of course, not touching the cornea and not touching the limbus. The advantage of using four curves is that I can then change the eccentricity or change how the lens fits in small steps instead of using two harsh steps. If you have used scleral lenses before with first generation sclerals, you see that some of them, they got very tight after a while. With these lenses, they are more aspherical, and then they sit gently in the tissues over the sclera. These are the curves of the standard Europa lens. As you can see, the optical zone is 8.5 millimeters, and then they have the width of the PC2, PC1, with 2.1 millimeters, and then up to 60 millimeters. The Europa lens, the standard lens, is 16.0. You can order, you have sets in 16.0, in 18.0, even in 20.0. Of course, these are made to order lenses, but with the 16.0, you can do almost anything, okay? Unless you have a advanced ectasia or a very, very large eye, okay? Good apical clearance, as any other lens, right? Apical bearing is not tolerated. You cannot have that, the picture on the right. There's a central board, go over it. This is the Ferris University, the chart that they use in order to teach us how to actually provide clearance or how to measure the clearance over the cornea of the lens. The green band, that will be the fluorescein at the reservoir, and then the cornea after that, okay? Of course, the same thing, don't worry. We're going to provide you with continuing education on how to fit these lenses. Like I mentioned before, the idea tonight is for you to have a really nice overview of all our products. Limbal clearance, we cannot touch the limbus. You should go over it, as you can see in the second picture. Next. This is the Ferris University chart on how to go over the limbal clearance. Of course, you with practice and education, you will know how to do this. Avoid impingement or compression. You see the good alignment on the left, too much compression on the right. With the old lenses, you usually have a lot of compression. With the new lenses in Europa, you can avoid that because the lens is more aspheric, and you have a lot of changes to do. For example, if you're using old lenses, sometimes some companies in order to avoid having compression, all you have to do is lift the peripheral area, lift the optics, right? Sometimes the older companies, all they provide you is to use lift, edge lift 1, 2, or 3, or flat 1, flat 2, or flat 3, and that's it. With Europa, since it is a full made to order lenses, you can actually order between 8 to 10 steps, okay? So you can actually, with a regular lens, you can order almost 300 microns of lift. With Europa, you can order, if you want, 1,000 microns of lift, okay? Let me tell you, I haven't needed to use that, but I have cases in which I have to order 500 microns. And then if I'm using all platforms, they won't provide me enough lift to avoid compression, okay? What are the advantages of using toric scleral haptics? Remember, from the latest technology or the latest research that we have done, the industry and the different researchers, the sclera is not spherical, it's toric. And then that's why now with the new technologies, we are able to offer you toric scleral optics to create a better lens to tissue relationship and to enhance comfort, okay? Our set comes with regular spherical optics and also with toric haptics. So you don't have to, if you need them, you have them right there on the set. You have to order those. You have a whole set with toric and spherical haptics to be able to fit your patients. It doesn't matter the actual shape of that specific sclera. Will provide you with the different tools, okay? Next. What are the indications of reverse geometry? And we talk about reverse geometry because Europa is a reverse geometry scleral lens. There are only a few lenses that are true reverse geometry. Reverse geometry is a lot better because it gives you the advantage of actually fitting actual ectasias that are not centrally, that are more peripheral, okay? Like PMD, the pellucid vaginal degeneration, asymmetric cones, corneal transplant, post-refractive surgery. You have better visual acuity, better contrast, better centration, also better oxygenation with reverse geometry lenses. Like I mentioned before, don't worry, we will provide you with continued education about this. Of course, this platform is actually the most custom-able platform available in the whole world. If you don't trust us, just look at different brands and you will see what we can do on Europa. With Europa, you can do everything you want. All the parameters are made to order. You can adjust those without any problems, okay? I dare you to compare to other sets, other companies, and you will see that what we're actually telling you is this is the most custom-able lens. You can either use toric or bitoric lenses. You can do less notching, even sclerals for presbyopia. Felipe is trying to write, if you can imagine it, we can do it for you.
Yes. So if you can dream of it, we can make it. And that's exactly what I tell people all around the world, is that this is a complete customized contact scleral lens. So this lens, you can make it quadra specific. You can make it, we can flatten in one meridian, we can steepen it in another meridian, we can make it toric, we can make it bitoric, we can make it with lens notching, we can also create a micro vault for people that have small pinguecula, small pterygiums. So it's completely customizable scleral lens.
It's very important. We keep in contact with you guys, because for the next year we will be giving a lot of webinars, a lot of training on how to do this. Probably later on we are discussing that we will actually visit some of you guys in different places with different symposiums, and the idea will be to actually introduce directly these different technology into your countries. This is the Europa Bitoric Scleral Lens Front Toric. From minus 0.25 to minus 15 in steps on 0.25, and we can even order those steps in 0.125. That's an eighth of a diopter. It is not strange for our Europa lens to have a power like minus 6.125, an eighth of a diopter. We do that because we really believe in actually customizing the actual fit. Instead of 0.25, we can always give you an eighth of the diopter in terms of power, or even base curve. The axis, all of the axis in one degree steps. We don't settle for 5 degrees or 10 degrees. We have 1 degree steps. And the toric aptis, as you can see over there, from 0.5 to 8 degrees, eight diopters. So that's almost 800 microns. Regular lenses, they go from 1 to 3 diopters. Our lenses, 8 diopters. As I mentioned before, there's no other platform more customizable than the Europa Scleral Lens. It is as simple as that. Next.
1 second.
These are the lens markings in the lenses. So the Europa lens is from Visionary Optics, and we are the distributors in the Caribbean and almost all of South America, okay? And the different lens markings, the diagnostic lens, the front toric, back toric, or bitoric lenses. We have everything for you. Next. We can do lens notching. If you have pinguéculas, if you have glaucoma valves, if you have pterygium, we can go around those. Do not create unnecessary pressure in those areas. Just avoid it by notching the lens or creating cuts and go around it. Next. Even Europa for presbyopia, if you have patients that they need specialty contact lenses, but that also presbyopes, we have the solution for you. We have a really nice platform. You don't need a set another set in order to fit patients with Europa purpose myopia, or you need the regular set, and then you provide us with the lens centration, the size of the pupil, the eye, and the dominant eye, and we can design for you a lens for that specific patient. All you have to do, the regular fit, and after you have the regular fit, let us know the eye powers, the size of the pupil, and which lens is dominant, and we can create the lens for you. Like any other custom lens available, we can either have center near or center far in these lenses without any problems. If you, whatever you like to design, we'll do it for you. Next.
Okay, so I want to show you something before the end of the presentation. I want what I wanted to do with every single practitioner is that we wanted to teach you, and we wanted every single person, not only the gurus around the world, to fit scleral lenses. So if you go to your website, to your web browser, I'm sorry, and you type in www.ssandsam.com, so again, www.spctinternational.com, SSM Sam, P as in Paul, C as in Charlie, international.com, you're going to go to specialty contacts, and you can choose either Spanish or English, okay? You can choose scleral lenses, and all the information that Dr. Davila talked about today is here. So you can see the fitting strategy, okay? And it will tell you exactly which lens to start with, okay? You can see the lens markings. You can see evaluation and troubleshooting. You can see the post-evaluation, and you can receive removal and application tips. But the most important part of this is that you can also see all the videos that you want on scleral lenses. So you can see videos from Abe van der Werf, Randy Kojima, Dr. Erga Davila, and multiple doctors around the world explaining scleral lenses to you. And you can do this in your comfort of your own home or your own practice. But what I wanted to show you is this. Free of charge. We want to be able to get you into this new system of fitting lenses. So if you don't know anything about scleral lenses, don't worry, you're not alone. We're gonna be with you the entire steps, we're gonna be there. So let's say that you're fitting a patient. Okay, patient Dr. Davila. Okay, this is a new order or a warranty. Let's say that it's a new order, okay? We're only fitting the right eye. Okay, let's say that I started with the lens 47 minus 5, 16.0 in the fitting set. Okay? So the first thing the system is going to ask me, do you have corneal clearance? Yes or no? Let's say yes. Okay, quantify that corneal clearance in 30 minutes. How much corneal clearance do you have between lens and cornea itself? So the rule when fitting scleral lenses is that you need to have between 200 to 300 microns of clearance when you first initial put the lens, right? So let's say that you have 150 microns in 30 minutes. You know that lens is going to settle. So maybe that is not ideal, but we're going to design that lens for you, okay? So the corneal clearance was ideal? No, it was not ideal because we only have 150 microns, okay? Do we need to subtract microns or add microns? If we told you that the rule is between 250 to 300 microns of clearance, so how many microns do you think that we need to add to this? Let's say 150. So you put 150, okay. So then you go to step number two, which is the limbal clearance. The limbal clearance, we need to have minimum of 50. What is it, Davila? 50, right?
50.
So, limbal clearance, do we have limbal clearance ideal? Yes or no? If you have 50, you're good. If you don't have good limbal clearance, you put add microns or subtract microns right here. Okay, the lens landing, is it ideal or not? Okay, let's say that is not ideal. Why is it not ideal? Do you have impingement? Yes, you can choose here what type of impingement you have. If you have severe, medium, or slight, let's say that we have slight impingement. What about blanching? Do you have blanching? Yes, we do have a little bit of blanching. What is your blanching? Severe, slight, or medium? Let's say that we have slight blanching as well. So what we will do is we will gather all this information and we will design a lens for you. Now, do you want to modify the edge? Okay. This is in Spanish, okay? Over refraction. The over refraction, -4, okay? Over refraction when -4. Do you have flexure? No. Okay, additional comments. The patient states the lens is fogging after a few hours of wear. We will take all of this data and we will calculate a lens for you. You can also put topographies, or you can add topographies or pictures or anything, and you just save this into your computer, put save as, and you send us pictures, fluorogram videos, or any tool that you might think that will help us understand this fit. And what we will do is, with all this data, we will design a lens for you. So you don't have to remember how to fit scleral lenses. We don't have to remember all the tools and all the tips that we have given you tonight. All you have to do is have the desire to start the scleral lens in the scleral lens world, and we will help you with everything that you need in order to be successful. Okay? In order to finish this presentation, now we're gonna talk about topographers. Dr. Davila?
Yes, we are also the distributors of Medmon. Members is considered to be the standard of care topographer for contact lens fittings in the whole world. Almost every school of optometry, every research place of contact lenses uses Medmon as a gold standard. Okay, so we are, like we mentioned before, we are the distributor for the Caribbean and almost all of South America. This is the famous corneal topographer that Randy Kojima helped to create, and that is the one that he uses in almost every one of the corneal topography lectures that he gives. Next. So this is the ultimate contact lens tool. The corneal topography is becoming the standard of care in order to be able to fit specialty contact lenses. We're not going to say that in order to fit specialty lenses you need a topographer, but if you do have them, you will be more efficient, a lot faster, and you'll have excellent results right away with the designs that you create. That's the advantage of using a topographer like this. If you remember years ago, 30 years ago, corneal topographers were very expensive. Nowadays, the cost of those has decreased a lot, and they are very affordable right now. So you don't have to go broke in order to get one of these instruments. That's one of the nice things about corneal topography. The price has gone down instead of up after two or three decades. A good topographer usually takes about 9 millimeters of the cornea. Remember, the HVID is about 11.8 in terms of average. The Medmon is the topographer with the biggest capture, but still we are not happy with that. We want to capture the whole cornea, and that's why we have either the single capture or we have what we call the composite eye captured. What that means is you take four, you can see here, five different pictures of the cornea, looking forward, looking up, down to your left and to your right, and the instrument is able to actually overlap all those images and create a single image. You'll see in the next slide how it is. Next. The first one, we're able to capture 10.3 millimeters of the cornea, and with the other, with the composite capture, you were able to gather the whole cornea, 11.7, and that, my friends, that means power. Information is power. So you are with the Medmon, you are able to actually measure the whole cornea. This is the only topographer in the market that actually does this, that you're able to measure the whole cornea with it. Like I told you before, a good topographer measures maybe 9.5. With the Medmon in single capture, is 10.3. In composite, you're able to measure the whole cornea, even the corneal scleral angle, and that is important because we're going to show you, because of the next slides, you're going to see what is important to measure the corneal scleral angle. Next. Also, this topographer, they have what we call the contact lens software. It helps you design with special fluorescent patterns, different type of lenses. You can actually create GP lenses with this design. You can also create or adjust or troubleshoot Ortho K lenses. You can even fit scleral lenses with the contact lens software that we provide you. So this is a big advantage. Not only you're able to measure the whole cornea, but with the contact lens software that is included. With the package, you can either design your own type of lenses or select from a wide array of designs that we have within the software. Next. Also, you can actually measure what we call the TR film surface quality. You can do some dry eye assessment with a special map that we use in the MedMon. The MedMon is able to give you the NIVUT, the non-invasive breakout time. It actually, the MedMon works as a video camera instead of a regular thing. It measures everything and give you the non-invasive because the camera is able to know when the actual tear breaks without using fluorescent at all. So it gives you a tear film quality assessment. So if you are into dry eyes, if you are on dry eye clinic, or usually helps you with eye clinics, usually helps you to determine if the patient needs to be able to be treated for dry eyes. Next. How accurate the MedMon? Very, very accurate. Now we have a lot of different stories actually giving you the how accurate this instrument is. So that's why it is considered to be the gold standard for corneal topography and especially contact lens fittings. Next. Can the MedMon be used to fit scleral lenses? Yes, you can fit scleral lenses using the MedMon. And you can see there are some different stories on how specific the lens is, or the lens measures the area in order to be able to fit scleral lenses. Next. In this area over here, you have what we call the attributes window. As you can see, next to the topography on the column on the left, in the bottom portion, you see something says EH cord. Next. With the EH cord is the measurements on your cornea, on your eye. And the nice thing about it is that you can even tell the topographer you want the cord attribute at which millimeters. For example, if you're using a 15.0 diameter lens, you can get the adjusted height at 15, or you can use 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, up to 19 millimeters. So it doesn't matter which lens you use, or you need to provide us with the diameter, and the actual instrument will provide you with the sagittal height needed to choose the base curve or the sag height for that first special lens in order to clear the whole cornea. Next. So the thing is, let's say that I estimated with the instrument 3,707 microns, we need to start, we use 400 of the apical clearance, so you will choose a lens with 4,100 microns. The thing is, with this topographer, you can actually measure the sagittal height that you need. Once you have the sagittal height, you go to your set of extra lenses and look for the closest one to 4,100, and that will be your starting base curve or your starting sagittal height in order to fit lenses. So yes, this is one of the will be the only topographer that have a special software designed to actually help you fit scleral lenses. This is the scleral lens software included with the package also. Ojo, detallado análisis that I mentioned before. Next. And that's why we say that the MedMonk is the gold standard. As you can see over here, we have software for scleral lenses. We have software for Ortho K lenses. We have software for GP lenses. We have software for dry eyes. And of course, all the maps that you need in order to actually assess the cornea with the different indexes. So this is the gold standard. We have we can orientate you regarding the use of the topographer, training videos. Like we mentioned before, you are never alone. With our consultants, we are able to provide you with everything you need in order to even do topography. Okay.
And if you go to our main website, which is www.spcinternational.com, at the top of the website or the URL, you're going to see an icon that says Spectrum University. I don't know if everybody can see it here, but I'm going to click on it. So you'd go to spcinternational.com, spctinternational.com, and on the upper right hand, there's going to be an icon. Just click on that icon, and you're going to see all kinds of webinars. So if you want to learn about soft specialty contact lenses, if you want to learn about GP lenses, if you want to learn about Ortho K, if you want to learn about hybrid lenses, if you want to learn about MedMonk equipment. So here you can find a presentation that was given by Randy Kojima and Dr. Edgar Davila. So you can find all kinds of resources and help that can help you interpret any of these designs or even fit patients. But again, we are here with you and we're not gonna go anywhere. So whenever you want to fit patients together, let's please get in touch so we can start helping you or introduce you to this amazing world specialty contact lenses. Guys, thank you so much for attending this webinar tonight. We're gonna go jump into the questions. We had a lot of questions from the participants, okay? And I'm gonna start answering them or referring them to Dr. Davila.
Yes, so we have, Dr. I'm sorry, we have 9 more minutes, so we're on the clock. Our goal was to actually have 2 hours, so we 10:21 here, so we have 9 minutes for questions. Of course, if we want to keep to stay here answering questions, I have no rush. I can stay here with you guys. Thank you for being with us. A lot of nice things are going to be given to you guys next. Let's keep in touch, and then let's see what we can plan in their different countries.
So let's go to the questions, Dr. Nigel San Jose from Trinidad and Tobago. Hello, Dr. Nigel. Is asking us, isn't the trend in contact lenses toward daily disposables? Yes, Dr. Nigel, if you want to stay in soft disposable contact lenses and you want to follow the American trend, yes, that's where the United States is going. But Latin America and the Caribbean are still using non-daily disposable contact lenses. If you talk to Siva Vision, if you talk to Alcon, if you talk to B&L, if you talk to Johnson & Johnson, they will tell you that the daily market in Latin America hasn't picked up. Why? Because patients in Latin America tend to wear the lenses longer, and also because opticians and optometrists in Latin America are also aware that when you fit a patient in daily disposable lenses, that patient is not going to come as often to your practice because he's going to have more lenses in his house. He's not going to need solutions. He's not going to need contact lens cases. And in most cases, they don't buy ophthalmic products either. So Latin America has been a resilient market for soft disposable contact lenses.
The other thing is, saludo, Dr. Nayo. The other thing is, even Magenovi, they have daily disposable lenses on their portfolio. But the thing that, like Felipe is saying, we are trying to offer everything to our customers. If you need them, we can provide them. But most of the modalities that they're using right now, most of them, of course, I know why Dr. Nayo San Rose asked the question, because, for example, in Trinidad, the usage of daily disposable is higher than in other countries in the Caribbean, even in Latin America. Probably that's why. But the thing is, we can probably with anything that you need. Okay.
My dear friend Wanda San Giovanni, I hope you're well. Wanda, greetings from Atlanta. Orion, can Orion be done in a multifocal option, Dr. Davila?
No. First of all, saludos. I have your set with me. Later on during the week, probably I'll give it to you, the Orion set. No, in the prosthetic or aesthetic lenses, you cannot do multifocals because of the color. There is no way, or there is not enough space to create two different areas of power and keep the color in anyways. And that's why with the Orion, you cannot do multifocals. In clears, you can do it with Mark Kenobi, maybe even you can do it with other lenses, but not in color lenses because there is not enough space to create two zones for far near.
Another question from Dr. Nigel. Can we use Duet for myopia control? Yes, Dr. Nigel, you can use Duet for myopia control.
And then the thing is, you can use it for myopia control, but if that's an important question, but that we have to clarify, if you're going to use Duet Progressive for myopia control, you have to make sure that you choose the center far. The center segment will be for far, not for near, because in order to do myopia control, you need far power in the center and then plus power in the periphery. So you have to use the center distance lens in order to do myopia control, not the center near lens. But the thing that's the nice thing about Duet. You can do whatever you want. We have center distance, center near. We even have plus five. So if you really want to do real myopia control, remember that some companies, they're actually offering you soft lenses for myopia control. But if you use only an ad of plus two or plus 250, you're not really doing a good myopia control. That's why Ortho K is a lot better than soft lenses. With this lens, we can provide you up to five diopters of plus power and then create that myopic defocus that you need in order to be able to provide myopia control. With a regular plus two, you won't be able to you won't have very good results. With a plus five, you can actually create that. Okay?
Dr. Soribet Cotto, saludos from Puerto Rico. She's asking, Edgar, do you use dominant and non-dominant in Duet to calculate distance and far?
Yes, the same thing. Even the calculator will ask you which one will be the dominant eye, and then you can provide the information and then calculate the lens. And the same platform over there, you can actually enter the information. They'll ask you for it, you provide it, and we'll create the lens for you.
And if not, you can just give us the information and we will design it. If you don't want to use a calculator, like Dr. Davila was saying, we will design it for you. Just give us all the information and we will input this in the calculator and just spit up a completely new lens for you so you can try it on your patient. Dr. Gonzalo Cardona from Puerto Rico. Greetings, Dr. Gonzalo. He has multiple questions. Do you have an example of an empirical fit using Duet multifocal? Yes, Dr. Gonzalo, I have multiple cases of Duet multifocal fit empirically. And do you have any limitations as far as the pupil diameter? No, you don't have any limitations as far as the pupil diameter. This is a fully customized lens, Dr. Gonzalo.
Yeah, you can. Well, the limits will be 1.8 to 4.0. The thing is, usually you don't need less than that or more than that, because that adjusts to the size of the normal sizes of the pupils of patients. It will be very rare to need less than 1 millimeter or to use more than 4.0 millimeters to adjust the zones. That's why it's completely made to order. You can adjust it. Also, remember, usually every company, the regular companies, they use from between 1.8 to 2.2. That's it. In our company, we can range from 1.8 to 4.0.
Another question from Dr. Gonzalo. How do you recommend to fit a patient that has keratoconus but is interested in wearing a multifocal lens?
Well, actually, the best way to do that will be using a scleral lens. With a scleral lens, in the case of Europa, you can order, you have the benefits of actually creating good visual acuity, and also you have the optics to create a multifocal lens. Of course, it depends on the severity of the cornea. If the cornea is completely scarred, probably the visual acuity won't be that good. But if you are able to get nice visual acuity or functional visual acuity at far, in some cases we can do a presbyopic lens for the patient and he should be able to see far and near clearly without any problems.
He's asking if we can select the thickness of the scleral lens in Europa. Yes, doctor, you can select the thickness that you want in the scleral lens, either to be thicker or to be thinner in the Europa lens, fully customizable lens as well.
Yeah, the thing is, always the set comes with a center thickness of 0.40. The idea behind that is that you have a set that they can last years, right? Because if the thicker it is, the longest it will last. But as Felipe mentioned, you can order the center thickness that you want. Today, I received a pair of lenses for a patient of mine with KC, and I ordered those lenses 0.25 instead of 0.40. You can order 0.25, 0.30, 0.35, whatever you need. Usually, anything below 0.25 will be strange because a big lens, a big 16 millimeter or 18 millimeter lens, less than 0.25 could actually get warped or get flexure. But you can order without any problems 0.25 as a central thickness for an Europa lens for keratoconus patients.
Okay, Dr. Rosado, thank you so much as well. He was thanking both of us. Well, thank you, doctors from the Caribbean. Thank you, doctors from Latin America. Thank you all for participating in this evening of new products and new technology. Let's please stop referring patients and let's stop giving the internet more business. We're here to help you. We're here to change your practice. And remember, we don't sell contact lenses. We build practices and we build professionals. Thank you so much for attending tonight. This webinar is going to be uploaded in our website in about 48 hours, but every single person that registered on this webinar is going to receive a link so they can save this webinar and they can review it in their own personal time. Thank you again, Dr. Davila. It was an amazing conference. Thank you for everything that you do for Spectrum, and thank you for everything that you do for the world. It's been more than 20 years that you've been teaching specialty contact lenses around Latin America, and we want to thank you for that. Thank you for everything that you do.
Thank you. Good night, everyone.
Thank you, guys. Have a good night.